Hello, hello! Welcome back to Exotic Wine Travel. I am your host, Matthew Orkey.
Hi, I'm Shireen Tan.
Welcome back to the show today. We are going to do a little bit of vertical tasting today.
A little bit, like two bottles.
I wish I could do
it. Fair enough, I like that.
A mini vertical tasting. So for those of you who don't know what vertical tasting is actually tasting the same wine through different years, different vintages, so you can kind of see the difference of the year and what they gave the winemaker, right?
Yeah, it really shows what each year would give to the wine, and also I think it's difficult for a person to understand the aging potential of a wine if you don't know how it would evolve, or you don't know like sort of like the track record or the history of a wine. So it's important. It's only when you have an idea of how it evolves over a couple of years, that's when you taste a new vintage, you have an idea of the aging potential of that bottle in that specific year.
And especially when you have wines like that are blends like these wines that we have, I think, you know, people that are just getting into wine think about it being just a romantic product. The grape grows, you make it into wine, yada, yada, yada. But the year gives different challenges. So in blends, you know, one grape might be a little bit ripe, one grape might not be as ripe. So you add a little bit more of this vintage. That vintage, you take some off. There's a lot of blending that goes into place. So it's just really interesting.
Yeah, I think it also contributes to each consumer or professional's knowledge as well when you taste verticals like that. Because at times, it may appear like, maybe for example, a 2014 rainy vintage for some countries, it may appear not as appealing at first, you know, with a lack of fruit, it was a wet year and things like that. But over time, in 10 years or something, some of these weaker vintages will catch up with a lot more finesse and elegance. So that's also something you can learn from vertical tasting.
Well, let's get into it. Rather than blabbing around, it's a fun thing to do. We've got some super Emilia Romagnans today. I just made up that term. Am I gonna be famous now?
Yeah.
Tuscany is famous for some of its Bordeaux blends and blends with Sangiovese, super Tuscans. So Emilia Romagna, why can't you have it? We have two. We have two vintages of the. Let me see if I pronounce everything right here. So the Palazzona di Maggio Dracone Riserva from 2009 and 11. These wines are mostly Merlot with Cabernet Franc
and a little. The bit of Petit Verdot.
And some Petit Verdot. Yeah. So, you know, Emilia-Romagna is a region famous for food. We were there 4 years ago. The food's incredible, right? Mm-hmm. And not so famous for wine besides Lambrusco. But there's some interesting wines here. And in this DOC, the Colli di Amola, there are actually some surprising good Bordeaux blends being made. Even though I feel like this DOC is kind of a silly DOC because you can just plant anything there. So it doesn't make any sense. Anyways, Dracone Reserva, age 24 to 30 months and 500 liter oak. Mm-hmm. And we tasted this at we tasted one of these vintages at a business-to-business meeting in Piemonte, and we were really shocked, right?
Yeah, particularly I was very high on this bottle because of where it comes from. It offers great value for money, and because it's not really famous for high-quality wine, so, you know, always support the underdog.
Okay, so let's give this a go here. We'll taste the 2011 first, and we'll go to 2009. We'll compare a little bit here. First of all, you're going to get a dark color, mm-hmm. deep dark color. Obviously, you're getting your Merlot, Petit Verdot, wines that have color. Mm-hmm. Let's give this a smell. I can smell it from here.
It's exactly what I remember it to be. A little graphite, a little bit of violet, black fruit.
Very
plum.
Pretty. You would, to me, this you would know is an Italian Bordeaux blend. Doesn't scream Bordeaux to me.
Mm.
You don't agree?
No, I'm just contemplating.
This is actually, I wasn't feeling so well today. Now I'm all like perked up by tasting this. It's got plum, graphite, a little bit of capsicum, this cherry tanniness that I kind of get all the time with central Italian reds. Just a little bit of mocha. Did I say mocha already? Let me get this go.
More coffee bean, I would say. Fresh coffee bean. Just amazing. This fruitiness, a bit of development. And the palate is quite full on the front palate.
Yeah.
But I don't think it sits very heavy on the palate. It has a lot of tanginess. Very good acidity. Finishes with quite a little bit of alcohol, but it's still very balanced.
And bone dry. bone dry for me. There's not a lot of residual sugar here. Is this maybe a little bit better? Is this better than you remember it? About the same?
It's the same. I really like this wine because for 25 euros retail price is pretty kick-ass. And for 2011, I believe this wine still has many more years ahead of it to evolve more and deliver more.
Yeah, it's, you know what? For being almost 8 years old, not super old. There's not a lot of tertiary notes. I'm not getting tobacco, mushroom, everything. It's still quite fresh. You know, right now for me, I'm about 90 out of 100, but that could change as we taste through the bottle. Mm. I think very good. And it's so food friendly. Mm. What do you think?
I really like the tannins as well. It's more towards the sweet tannins, a little bit sandy, but it still sits very nicely on the palate. Very nice, long finish.
Imagine this with some tagliatelle.
Did you just finish the wine already?
Yeah, I liked it. Okay. With some tagliatelle. I'm in a good mood now after drinking. All right, next. Palazzo di Maggio. Palazzone di Maggio was nice enough to send us old vintage 2009 Dracone Reserva. Same blend, Merlot, Cabernet Franc, and Petit Verdot. I just want to make sure we have something up for tonight. Kidding here. This is 2009, so this is 10 years old now. Same process, 24 to 30 months. What we could find, although, I haven't been tasting with this winery for a long, long, long time. Mm-hmm. I think 7 was the first vintage they did this, from what we found.
As far as I know from what I searched online, it's 2007. This is immediately, I can tell the nose, it seems a little bit older than 2011. You get more of this hay, dry herb, Mediterranean herb note for me on the nose.
I'm so, you know, 9 already feels like a hotter year to me. The fruit, even though there's more tertiary, it feels a little more plush. I don't know what 9 and 11 was like in Emilia Romagna. I know they were good vintages in Tuscany, which is the province right to the south. Of course, not as good as 2010 was just a legendary vintage in Tuscany. So I'm imagining 9 and 11 were similar, because about similar, you get excited. So yeah, sorry, you can interrupt me.
No, that's fine. No, I'm perfectly calm.
I get a touch of dried mushroom tobacco, but then other than that, very similar profile to here. I get plum, mocha, some it. Black cherry.
Taste it.
Okay. I want to taste it. Not as much fruit up front as the 11. For me, more tertiary. Tannins are a little bit more dry, but it's more of a developed wine, so I really like it. It's charming me. What about you?
I prefer 11 if I want to just jump right straight to conclusion, because 11 has more broadness and defined structure. But I think some people may like 9, right? Because it's obviously more developed, a little bit more tertiary, less primary fruit. But it has, again, a certain silky elegance to it on the palate.
It doesn't have a lot of tomato leaf, a lot of tobacco. So that tells me, okay, this wine's not super long, but it has some more time. I think it can go. If you want some more of that tomato leaf, some of the tobacco, some of that tertiary stuff, you can go a little bit farther with 9. I'm really enjoying it. It's just, for me, it's kind of, this is definitely flamboyant and Italian-y, central Italian-y. This is a little more Frenchy to me, a little bit more round and balanced. What do you think? You don't agree with me?
No. I just think they're more or less the same profile for me, because like I said, for 2009, I get that Mediterranean herb, which is very Mediterranean and Italian to me, so.
I think I would go probably about 90 on this, and probably 91 probably on this. We'll have to taste through to see. Can I have a more definitive conclusion? So what's this taught you about these wines, this little mini vertical tasting?
I think it's very important to, if you have the capacity and the storage, right? Important to get a couple of bottles of the same vintage if you really like a wine, and make sure you taste it once a year or so. Because for me, 2009 is a little bit past the prime for my palate. Although I think a lot of people would have actually appreciated being evolving a little bit more.
I actually taste it. I think it's become, they're both very, very enjoyable wines. So great job. I was really surprised to see wines of this quality I know I've tasted some fantastic wines in Emilia Romagna, but a lot of times you find just kind of average table wines. These are super high quality, serious wines that are going to impress a lot of people, right? Yeah.
In terms of points, actually, I am 1 point higher than you. I will score this 92 points.
Wow.
I really think this is a very good wine.
Wow.
Potentially even a plus behind.
Oh.
I do think it's a very good wine. And drink now and within the next 2 years or so for this. Actually, I'm a little bit less than you. I think it's 89 because I think it could have been a better wine. And I'm sad to know it today because I think maybe in 2 years ago, it might be a better wine. But yeah, this is...
So this is cool. If we had all the vintages, then you could... This is the current release, which is how crazy is that? How cool is that? So you could get a little bit more. But, you know, nice job. Check out some of these wines. You know, I'll put them in the description box. Anything else to add? You want a vertical tasting these wines? Emilia Romagna, Italy?
It's just do more of this sort of tasting.
Yeah. So guys, check it out. And if you like this video...
Please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Exotic Wine Travel.
I will see you at the next episode.